Good evening from the New Jersey Performing Arts Centre. You're all very welcome as we Irish celebrate through music, song and dance our heritage and the common bond of friendship with this great country, America. The sun was declining beneath a blue sea when I strayed with my love to the pure crystal fountain that stands in the beautiful Vale of Tralee. She was lovely and fair as the rose of the summer, yet was not her beauty alone that won me. Oh no, 'twas the truth in her that made me love Mary, the Rose of Tralee. The cool shades of evening, their mantle spreading, and Mary all smiling was listening to me. The moon through the valley her pale rays was shedding when I won the heart of the Rose of Tralee. Oh, lovely and fair as the rose of the summer, yet was not her beauty alone that won me. Oh, no, 'twas the truth in her eyes that made me love Mary, the Rose of Tralee. You've all heard of the old Irish saying, it's no use crying over spilt milk. And in this next song, it just shows you that sometimes spilling the milk can be a very profitable thing to do. The song is called Kitty of Coleraine.
As beautiful Kitty one morning was tripping with a pitcher of milk from the fair of Coleraine, when she saw me she stumbled, the pitcher it tumbled, and all the sweet buttermilk watered the plain. What shall I do now? 'Twas looking at you now, for sure such a picture I'll ne'er meet again. 'Twas the pride of me dairy, oh Barney McClary, your scent as a plague on the girls of Coleraine. I sat down beside her and gently did chide her that such a misfortune should give her such pain. A kiss then I gave her, and before I did leave her, she vowed for such pleasure she'd break it again. It was haymaking season, I can't tell the reason. Misfortune will never come single, 'tis plain. Far very soon after poor Kitty's disaster, there wasn't a pitcher left all in Coleraine.
You know, one of my fondest memories as a boy, you know, growing up in Ireland, was visiting my granny. Every day after school, she had one of these old gramophones with the horn and the handle. That was my job, you know, turning the handle. But she had a great record collection. She loved singers, and of course her favorite singer of all was John McCormack. I can still see her sitting there in the old armchair with her eyes closed and a gentle tear, listening to Mother Machree.
There's a spot in my heart which no colleen may own. There's a depth in my soul never sounded or known. There's a place in my memory, my life, that you feel no other can take it, no one ever will. Sure, I love the dear silver that shines in your hair and the brow that's all furrowed and wrinkled with care. I kiss the dear fingers so toil-worn for me. Oh, God bless you and keep you, Mother. Sorrow or care in the dear days gone by was made bright by the light of the smile in your eye. Like a candle that's set in a window at night, your fond love has cheered me and guided me right. Sure, I love the dear silver that shines in your hair and the brow that's all furrowed and wrinkled with care. I kiss the dear fingers so toil-worn for me. Oh, God bless you and keep you, was a miller's daughter fair. She had admirers everywhere, but she loved best a fisher boy, and his attention she'd enjoy. He couldn't bear to part from her. He longed to give his heart to her, but in her tantalizing way, laughingly she would say, "Don't be cross, dear, don't sit and sigh, you'll recover by and by. I'm still young and want to be free, don't you see? You are not the one for me." She went in search of wealth and fame. Somehow the right man never came. Then when she found her hopes were vain, sadly she turned back home again. She left her foolish pride behind, told her true love she changed her mind. Asked him to marry her, but he answered her laughingly, "Don't be cross, dear, please don't cry, you'll recover by. Not the one for me." Oh, he cries. Please don't cry, though I loved you desperately. Now I see.
Boy, all this dancing. When I was a young fella, like in Clonmel, you know, my mother brought me down. I was about that height, and she brought me down to the local dance hall. They were looking for Irish dancers, I remember, at the time, you know. And Mammy kind of was so proud of me and that. And so anyway, there were about 200 or 300 of us all in rows. They put us in rows. And then they played a jig, and we all did the jig, you know. And then the dancing masters kind of went up and down the lines looking at us, you know. And then when the dancing master came opposite me, he said, "You out." That was the end of it. No Michael Flatley. No Michael Flatley. Now I'm going to bring you on a little tour of Ireland, the four provinces. We're going to begin up in Donegal, the hills of Donegal. Then we move down the coastline a bit for Galway Bay, representing Connacht. And then into Munster, my own province, for Slievenamon, a beautiful love song from Tipperary. Then over to Dublin, good old Dublin in the rare old times. And then finally, back to Ulster one more time for the last verse of Phil Coulter's immortal song, in which he expresses the hope and the prayer that someday peace will return to the town he loved so well. Oh, night and day I'm dreaming of the hills of Donegal, the heather on the hill, and the sun shine over all. And 'tis westward I'll be going,
across the ocean blue, to wake again the happy hours that long ago I knew, that long ago I knew. Oh, hills of Donegal, to me you ever call. In every wind that wanders o'er the wild and lonely sea, and please God, if He so wills, soon I'll see my Irish hills, the hills of Donegal, so dear to me. Sit and watch the moon rise over Cradle, and see the sun go down on Galway Bay, just to hear again the ripple of a trout stream, the women in the meadows making hay, or to sit beside a tar fire in a cabin and see the sun go down on Galway Bay. Alone in the crowded hall, the hall it is gay and the waves are grand, but my heart is not there at all. It flies far away by night and by day, times and the joys that are gone, and I never shall forget the sweet maiden I met in the valley near Slievenamon. On songs and stories, heroes of renown, the passing tales and glories that once was Dublin town, the hallowed halls and houses, the haunting children's rhymes, that once was Dublin city in the rare old times. Ring a rosy as the light declines, I remember Dublin city in the rare old times. Ring a rosy as the light declines, I remember Dublin city in the rare old times. but they still carry on, though their spirit's been bruised, never broken. They will not forget, for their hearts are all set on tomorrow and peace once again. For what's done lost is lost and gone forever. I can only pray for a bright, brand new day in the town
gentlemen, just give them a big welcome, the Eilidh O'Grady Irish Harp Orchestra.
The Corrocks are sailing away. laden with herring of silvery hue. Silver the herring and silver the sea, and soon there'll be silver for baby and me. Hear the wind blow, love, hear the wind blow. Lean your head over and hear the wind blow. The carracks tomorrow will stand on the shore, and Daddy goes sailing, a sailing no more. The nets will be drying, the nets heaven blessed, and safe in my arms, dear, contented you'll rest. Hear the wind blow, love, hear the wind blow. Lean your head
Ireland's greatest heroes was Joseph Plunkett. He was a teacher, a poet, gentle scholar, but he was prepared to make the ultimate sacrifice for his country. During the 1916 uprising, he was captured and, together with the other leaders, was sentenced to death. The night before his execution, he married his fiancée, Grace Gifford, in the little chapel of Kilmainham Jail. And this song tells of his last hours and final thoughts.
As we gather in the chapel here in Auld Kilmainham Jail, I think about these past few weeks. Oh, will they say we fail? From our school days they have told us we must yearn for liberty. Yet all I want in this old place is to have you here with me. Oh, Grace, just hold me in your arms. Dawn and I will die. With all my love, I'll place this wedding ring upon your finger. There won't be time to share our love, for we must say hard for you, my love, to ever understand the love I bear for these brave men, my love for this dear land. But when Parry called me to his side down in the GPO, I had to leave my own sick bed. To him I had to go. Oh, Grace, just hold me in your arms and let this moment linger. Then take me out at dawn and I will die.
Delighted to have as our special guest the celebrated Irish concert violinist Geraldine O'Grady. Please give her a warm welcome now as she's joined by her daughter Una Cure for a duet rendition of Chardash by Monty, on this occasion with an Irish twist.
Thank you.
sensation, darkness storms and wakes imagination. Silently the senses abandon their defenses. Slowly, gently, night unfurls her splendor. Grasp it, sense it, tremulous and tender. Turn your face away from the garish light of day. Turn your thoughts away from cold and feeling light, and listen to the music of the night. Close your eyes and surrender to your darkest dreams. Part all thoughts of the world you knew before. Close your eyes, let your spirit start to soar. Surround you, feel it, hear it, closing in around you. Open up your mind, let your fantasies unwind in this darkness which you know you cannot fight. The darkness of the music of the night. Let your mind take a journey to a strange new world. Leave all thoughts of the world you knew before. Let your soul take you where you long to be. Intoxication, touch me, trust me, savor each sensation. Let the dream begin, let your darker side give in to the power of the music that I write. The power of the music of the night.
This next song is very dear to my heart. Like all parents, my wife Eileen and I have taken great pride and joy in watching our son Aenon grow up. We think he's wonderful. Aenon joins Eileen and I now, and we dedicate this beautiful song to parents everywhere.
Son, you are the seed of life in me. And now I can't believe the man I see. With pride, I watched you grow up. You wanted so much to change the world for me. My son, you gave my simple life its key. Through you, I see God's love and mystery. You built up my love. Melody belongs to you and me, my song. Gladly die if it saved you from the heartache, the fear and all the bad breaks that tear your world apart. My son, you faced the truth and you stood tall. Goodbye, but you must go on living. And when my life is through, I'll always be with you, my one and only son. Watch you now with pride. What more is there to life than you and I, my soul?
Thank you, folks. Thank you, Amy. Super. This is a lovely selection of Irish American favourites. So join in with me, folks. This is your big chance now.
My one. Search everywhere, but none can compare with my wild Irish rose. Come on. Beautiful. The sweetest flower that grows, and someday for my sake she may let me take the blue.
Really sang along there. Marvellous, marvellous singing altogether. One of the great social events of rural Ireland was the traditional dancing at the crossroads. Musicians gathered and people came from miles around for a ceilidh, a night of laughter, music and dancing under the stars. Now, as we recapture this tradition, an American version, if you will, of dancing at the crossroads.
Thank you.
I'm going to sing now one of the most popular of all the Irish songs over the last few years. It's a song that was inspired by the great tragedy of the famine in Ireland, written by the Dublin songwriter Pete St. John. And it's based on a true story. It tells of a young man who, in order to feed his starving family, is forced to steal some corn. He's captured and tried, and then sentenced to penal servitude for life in faraway Botany Bay in Australia, the fields of Athenry.
By a lonely prison wall, I heard a young girl calling, "Michael, they are taking you away, for you stole Travel." Now a prison ship lies waiting in the bay. Oh, lie the fields of Athenry, where once we watched the small free birds fly. Round the fields of Athenry, by a lonely prison wall, I heard a young man calling. Nothing matters, Mary, when you're free. Against the famine and the crown, I rebelled, they ran me down. Now you must raise our child with dignity. Lord, lie the fields of Athenry, where once we watched the small free birds fly. Our love was on the wing, we had dreams and songs to sing. It's all only round the fields of Athenry. Star falling as that prison ship sailed out against the sky. Sure she'll wait and hope and pray for her love in Botany Bay. Dreams.
About John McCormack, they're back around the early 1900s. While he was making the Irish songs known and loved all over America, his great friend Enrico Caruso was doing the same for the Italian songs. So for all of you, and particularly for all our Italian friends, here is O Sole Mio, sung by an Irish tenor. Thank you.
the pipes are calling from glen to glen and down the mountain side. The summer's gone and all the roses falling. Tis you must go, and I must bide. But come ye back when summer's in the meadow, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow. Tis I'll be
thank you.
hath sounded for the trumpet that shall never call retreat. He is sifting out the hearts of men before his judgment seat. Oh, be swift, my soul, to answer him, be jubilant, my feet, our God is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His troop is marching on.
So let's all join together now in Irish Eyes Are Smiling. What about that? We're both singing it, the fella says.
There's a tear in your eye, and I'm wondering why, for it never should be there at all. With such power in your smile, sure a stone you'd beguile, and there's never a teardrop should fall. When your sweet lilting laughter's like some fairy song, and your eyes twinkle bright as can be, you should laugh all the while, and all other times smile. So now smile a smile for me. When Irish eyes are smiling, sure it's like a morning spring. In the lilt of Irish laughter, you can hear the angels sing. When Irish hearts are happy, all the world sees bright and gay. When Irish hearts are happy, all the world sees bright and gay. And when Irish eyes are smiling, sure they're steal your heart away.
Thank you, folks. What a night. What a great night. Bye-bye, folks. Thank you. God bless you all.